Now let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing today with our Bureau Chief, TJ Manotto.
Good morning, Mike and Nikki. Here are the latest stories making the headlines amongst the Filipino community.
We go to Vancouver, where more than 20 Filipino-Canadian families have lost their homes to a fire at this apartment building on East 12th Street in the early morning of December 13. North Vancouver School Board Trustee Leilani Tumaneng said almost half of the residents in the 62-unit building are Filipinos. The affected residents were brought to temporary shelters, some to a hotel in North Vancouver, and the rest to a UBC dormitory where they could stay until mid-January. The tragedy is more devastating for the victims as Christmas is just around the corner.
Wala akong nadala, hindi ako nakapasok kahit nakuha ko lang yung ito, yung bag ko, yung susi ng car ko, at saka yung phone namin. Yung passport itself naming pamilya andun sa isang bag, hindi malocate ng firefighters.
Very overwhelming, stressful, tsaka syempre mahirap maghanap ng bahay ngayon kasi maghanap.
Still in Vancouver, it was a sold-out screening for FAMA's Best Picture awardee, Katips, at the auditorium of the Simon Fraser University. Attorney Vince Tanyada, who also won as Best Actor for his role in the film, said Katips aims to inspire Filipinos to act on issues that need to change and to combat the proliferation of disinformation in the Philippines. Katips was adapted from the stage musical of the same title, which depicts the struggles of students during martial law and the human rights abuses that they suffered under the Marcos regime.
From the kind of like jovial, happy musical sections to the pretty graphic and visceral scenes of torture, murder, and sexual assault forces the audience to think about the disconnect between what is usually touted as like the golden age of martial law versus what actually happened.
Katips was screened in the major cities of Canada in collaboration with various Filipino-Canadian activist groups. And finally, we head to Los Angeles, where Miss Universe Philippines Celeste Cortezi has just landed, dressed in her white sweatsuit and waving the Philippine flag. As she excitedly greeted her fans, she says she's well-rested and ready to reach her dream of becoming Miss Universe.
I slept the whole time, 13 hours. So, you know, I'm just very happy to be here. This is my first time in LA. And of course, my whole team is here. I'm just very grateful and I cannot wait to start this experience. It feels so real right now. And I just cannot wait to meet all the candidates. I cannot wait to go to New Orleans and finally start the journey.
With the Miss Universe pageant some 3 weeks away, Cortez's team will have their final preparations in Los Angeles before they head to New Orleans. Miss Universe Philippines creative director Jonas Gafwood said they will rest for a few days as they wait for more members of the team to join them in the U.S., where they will concentrate on a few aspects of the competition.
She really has to like know how to do her own makeup. I mean, she knows, but like the stage makeup and everything. Her own hairstyle, that's where she's like, she finds it very difficult to do her own hair. So we will concentrate on that. And the final fittings for everything.
We will have to polish everything, the trainings, the rampa, the Q&A, also my gowns and my fittings. And I just want to enjoy the experience.
And those are the top stories amongst the Filipino community in North America. You can catch more of our stories online at news.abs-cbn.com/tfcnews and on the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel.